Hi, my name is Mary Kay Ball, and I'm one of the reference librarians here at the Barberton Public Library. And for today's quarantine craft corner, we're going to make this really cute little pot. And this is something you can do at home with things that you already have in your house. So what are you going to need for the little pot, the button pot? You're going to need a pot, and you can get one either at a craft store, or maybe you have something in your garage that was from last year. But if you don't have a pot, there's some other things you can use, like a tin can that you've rinsed out and you cleaned, but if you're going to have little fingers using them, you might want to put a little bit of tape around the top. Maybe have a grown-up help you with that. And if you have a jar would also work. And a lot of us have these little ball jars and things like that in the house, so these are also good to have. You will also need lollipop sticks. You can get these at the craft store or online now, using lollipop sticks in the cake baking decoration section. If you don't have the lollipop sticks, you can use pencils or twigs. And I got these yesterday in my front yard, and I'm pretty sure everybody has a nice set of twigs in their yard. And on my walk yesterday, I picked some up along the way, but be careful, don't go into strangers' yards and take the twigs without their permission. I don't think I need to say that, but in the interest of self-preservation, you might want to make sure. There are plenty of twigs around, and I'm sure your kids will love to clean up your neighbor's yard and get a nice set of twigs. Okay, another thing you'll need, scissors. Buttons. And you can ask your friends and neighbors, let me clean up my mess, for their buttons. For this project, I asked my co-workers and I got some nice set of buttons, and these all come with our clothes. When you get some new clothes, there's some extra buttons, or they've fallen off and you don't know where they belong. So we used to have button boxes when I was a little girl. So maybe you still have something like that. But you can use these buttons. You can also order them from the craft store. We really like the real colorful buttons. Those are fun. And maybe a little bit of some flowers things. You can get these outside now with the fresh flowers. And some washi tape. And washi tape is craft tape. And, or if you're really crafty, floral tape. And I think that's it for all the stuff. Oh, you need hot glue or craft glue. I have Elmer's and tacky glue. Elmer's worked on these. And you might need some hot glue, especially the hot glue. We're going to hot glue the buttons to the sticks. Okay, are we all set? And we could have some embellishments too. You can put on your pot. So we put these all on at the end. So let me get this out of the way. And because it's COVID-19 and the coronavirus, you might want to have some wipes so you can wipe off your pot stuff to make sure it's nice and safe. Okay. Are you ready to go? Okay. All right. What I did, I had some already done before. I took some washi tape and wrapped a couple of sticks with them, the different colors. If you don't have washi tape, you can go au naturel and just use them the way they are. I suppose you could probably color them with a Sharpie or with paint, but that's going to mess up your fingers a bit, but that's up to you. And you also need some foam. And if you don't have foam, styrofoam peanuts, and we have a lot of those lying around with all the packages and stuff you've been receiving, or you could put some pebbles in the bottom, that will also work. And you'll need a little bit of moss. This is Spanish moss, and you can get this at the flower stores, at the craft stores. If you don't have moss, shredded newspaper will work, or Easter grass, and I'm sure there's probably plenty of Easter grass around after yesterday's Easter celebrations. All right, well, what I did ahead of time is that I cut the foam. This is called Oasis foam, and I cut it to fit the pot. So you can, I used a plastic knife that you use from your lunch or from picnics and things like that, and the little fingers could use this because it's not too sharp, or you can have a grown-up cut it for you. And then you put it in your pot, inside of the pot. like so. Now I'm going to glue on some buttons. So I got some nice color buttons here, and I have my hot glue gun over here. So excuse me while I go glue my stick. Put a little dab of glue on the button, and you can layer your buttons. Like with these, I had three, but it's all up to you how much you want to do. And then you just stick it into the foam like this. And once you decide where you want it to go, you can also put some glue on your stick and stick it in the foam, but then it'll be in there permanently. So, and then when you're all done and you decided that's what I want, these are all the sticks that I want, these are all the buttons I'm putting on my sticks, then you can add some of the our little extra flowers and things. And I was thinking, these are nice little gifts to use in time for Mother's Day is coming up, and there's some other celebrations too, but these might also make some nice gifts for your neighbors that are next door that maybe are stuck in the house and could use a little cheering up. So maybe when you're all done, you can have the kids make a bunch and deliver them around, but you'll probably have to make sure that they're all cleaned up with your little sanitary wipes. But I think that might be a nice little gift to do. So let me glue my here. And you can also put some buttons and embellishments around the rim of the pot. That's what I did with these. And I just used Elmer's glue for that. You can also use a little bling and put that around the rim, and that'll be really cute. It takes a little bit for them to dry, but not too long. And if you want, you can hot glue them all on and they'll be on quickly, but you have to watch your fingers. This is a real tiny pot, so you have to make sure you don't burn your fingers. I'll add in your buttons onto your pot. And I got some of these buttons. There's some at the craft store. There's also a really neat site online called the Oriental Trading Company. And they have all kinds of crafts and things for parties and all kinds of things that the library uses for our projects. So that might be some other place to go to check. They will deliver through the post office. It's called the Oriental Trading Company. And with this, you just add a little bit of glue to the end of the little floral things, and you stick that also into the foam or into your pot or into the pebbles and stuff that you might have. Add a your moss, and be careful with this because it goes all over the place. It's called Spanish moss, but like I said before, if you don't have Spanish moss, you can use Easter grass or shredded paper, and you can see I'm making a mess, which is why you need some newspaper. If you don't want it all over the floor, get it in, get mom some more things she has to do, unless you're in charge of vacuuming at your house. And when you're all done, there's some ribbon you can put around the leaves, for the sticks. Or you can use like some chenille stems that I have here. When I worked at the craft store, they were called chenille stems, but in my world, we call them pipe cleaners. So you can use these, take your scissors, snip them off, and they become your leaves. Yeah, as long as they fall off. Well, you get the idea, right? I think that's it. I know it's a little bit of a mess here, but this is what your pot will look like, and hopefully it'll look like this when you're all done. So what we would like is if you do this project, post some of your little flower pots and tell us who got them, who did you give them to for a gift. So hope you had a lot of fun making these. These were fun, and they're cute, and it doesn't take too much time or supplies. So hope you have a wonderful day, and stay home, stay safe, and be healthy.